Hello everyone! Again, I'm going to try the acrylic bloom technique, but this time on some wooden coasters. And I'm also going to add a resin layer after they are dry. But yeah, I say that I'm trying it because I'm struggling a lot with this technique. And so you can see I already did some pores, but I scraped them. So I started with black, and it's the Boom Gel Stain Willy Wagtail Black, and on top also a Boom Gel Stain, but then in the color Pearlescent Teal, and on top some nice purple. It's one of my micropigments, it's the Crocus Magic, and now I'm using again a Boom Gel Stain, but then in the color Crepe Blue. But you can also see me struggle now because, yeah, it's all because of those chemical reactions between the different paints and the pouring medium and, of course, the cell activator. So I'm starting with a black cell activator and it's made out of the Willy Wagtail Black, and they also have a Boom cell activator, but you can also use it for a pouring medium, and the ratio is 1:1, so one part of this CA and one part paint. I'm pouring a little bit of black around it. So before this pour, I already tried different pours, but I didn't like them. And that's why I'm saying that I'm struggling with it. I'm using my airbrush to blow the cell activator over the colors. And I'm getting some lacing, but I'm still not pleased with it. Maybe it's because of my airbrush. So I'm watching a lot of videos to see how I can create that nice lacing. And those paints, those Boom Gel Stain paints, you don't have to add anything to it. You can use it straight out of the jar because all the pouring medium and all the ingredients are already in the paint. But the Crocus Magic, it's a mica pigment. And what I did is I added 1 teaspoon into my cup. And then I added a little bit of Jo Sonja's gloss varnish to disperse those mica pigments. And then I added an untinted base paint. And that untinted base paint I got from my paint store. Normally they use it for mixing their colors in their paint machine or mixing machine. But I got it without any color in it. So I wasn't satisfied with the black cell activator, and that's why I'm using a white cell activator on top of it. And I made it again with a Boom CA and pouring medium and the Stirling Wax White in a ratio of 1:1. And again, I'm trying to blow that white on top of those colors with my airbrush. Maybe next time I need to blow myself. But yeah, it's all about those chemical reactions between those paints and pouring medium. So what you see now is that I'm trying to save my coasters because I love the colors. They are great. And I'm getting some lacing, small cells, but maybe they will grow larger. because that pearlescent teal is looking great on top of that black. It has a really nice shimmer. Going to add some black to cover my whole coaster. And these four wooden coasters are 10 centimeters. They are not that thick, but it isn't necessary. So all the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box below this video, with the links to the websites, as I always do. Now I'm going to tilt my coaster to let it slide over the sides, and maybe I can make those cells a little bit larger that way. Adding a little bit more paint. There you can see it, I use it straight out of the jar, not added anything to it. So the lacing is not perfect, but I still like it so far. Hopefully they will dry also this way. Because what I already mentioned, I want to add a resin layer on top of it. You can already see the shimmer of the pearlescent teal a little bit. So also, I'm also struggling with some technique, so don't think I don't have any struggles. I also have them, and also in resin. But I always have the intention to make something out of it that I like. And I think that white cell activator, that white color on top of those other colors look very pretty. The cells are getting a little bit larger. That's nice. So for sure I'm going to try this again. Maybe change my paint mix a little bit. Because what I hear from other artists is that it's very important that the paint consistency is the right one. I have a drip in my white cell activator. I don't like it, so that's why I'm using my palette knife to make something out of it. And I'm very pleased that also my mica pigments work for this technique. So if you're interested in my mica pigments, the link to my Etsy shop is in the description box below this video. I have different kind of mica pigments. I have some pearl, but also very sparkly mica pigments. And those are not suitable for this technique, only the pearl mica pigments, because the particles, the mica particles, are much finer than the sparkly ones. The Crocus Magic, the pearl, the purple color is a fine mica pigment, so then it will dissolve in the untinted base paint. And if you want to try this technique, make sure that your untinted base paint dries clear. So if there is titanium in it and you mix your mica pigments in it, then the color will get pastel, and that's not nice. So I'm done. Now I'm going to let this dry for 2 weeks, and then I'm going to add a resin layer. So we are 2 weeks later, and they dried very well, and they are not perfect. The lacing is not perfect, but I still like them, and I'm still experimenting. Maybe I need to change my paint mix, I'm not sure yet. But I'm still going to add that resin layer, and I'm using the ArtPro resin from the Resin Pro company. So I'm starting in the middle with my resin, and then I'm working my way to the outside. And of course I taped the other side of the coasters, so that, because I will let it flow over the sides, and then you get drips. And if you add that tape on the other side, then you can remove the drips very easy. So that's what I did, spreading the resin over the surface. So what I mentioned, they are not perfect, lacing is not perfect, but I still like them. At the end of this video I'll show you all a close-up, then you can see the colors much better and a nice sparkle in it. And you don't need a lot of resin. I think I used only a little bit more than 40 gram, so that's not much. Using my heat gun to remove some air bubbles. Spreading it with my fingers onto the sides. There you can see the lacing. Not perfect. Maybe the cell activator, maybe I will make it a little bit thicker. But it's a lot of testing with this technique. So I'm almost done with my resin layer, and then need to let this dry for 24 hours, and then I will show you all the end result. So we are 24 hours later, and I have the coasters outside in the daylight. This is the end result. Now you can see the lacing. Not perfect, but I still like it, so let me know what you think. And for sure I'm going to experiment more with this technique, with different paint mixes and thickness, and also trying other mica pigments. So if you like what I'm doing, consider to subscribe. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video. The links to all the supplies I've used you can find in the description box below this video. And also my promo codes. I have several promo codes, the link to my Etsy shop, and also the link to my Facebook group. So if you want to join and show your art, you are all welcome. So I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you all in the next video. Bye!